Hey everyone, it's Scott from certmedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you another awesome Cloudflare tip that you can deploy on your website to further improve your load time, but also to reduce the load on your server. Truly, Cloudflare is my favorite CDN service. I love using the page roles, the workers, API, and so many other bits of its functionality that I have a lot of interesting tips that I've stumbled across over the years. I showed you how to cache the REST API, but this is another common thing that I see people do when they have Cloudflare and they serve video content. Now, the only time I recommend serving video content from your own server is if you're serving it as a background video. And the reason I recommend that is background videos in WordPress don't really need to load extra JavaScript. But if you load that video from, say, YouTube, you'll be loading the entire YouTube layer, which can be a very negative impact on your performance. This being said, you can also tell Cloudflare to cache your video uploads. Now, I'm also going to be showing you a secondary tip of how to extend the maximum lifetime of an item in cache so that way you save more bytes on your hosting transfer limits. So we're going to hop right into the page rules section. We're going to be creating a new page rule, and it's just one quick simple page rule, but it's actually really useful. You're going to be putting in the star, and then you're going to put in the website that you're working on. And then you're going to go WP-content, and you're going to go uploads. You're going to put a star after it, so anything that's after the star will get matched. Another thing you can do is if you're using something like WooCommerce or other items that add to the WP-content folder, you can, in theory, just go like this, and this will match everything in the WP-content folder. But for most use cases, stick to the uploads folder, just to avoid any strange issues with certain plugins that you might be using. What you're going to do then is you're going to first go to the edge cache TTL rule. As I've said in other videos, this rule is a suggestion to Cloudflare. It is not a solid guarantee. What it will do is it'll tell Cloudflare this is the maximum allowed time an item is allowed to remain in cache. The reason that you have the maximum is because if Cloudflare sees that a resource is not being requested frequently, it drops it from cache, and then you get a cache miss if the resource isn't widely requested. And the reason for this is it saves resources on their part, and it also allows them to reallocate resources to something on your website that may be getting downloaded a lot. For instance, a featured image you have on a post from 5 years ago may very well not be getting hit very often, but your main CSS style sheet will be getting downloaded a lot. So you have to make the CDN automatically optimizes the delivery for you, but it's still important to extend the maximum duration to avoid cache misses, especially on popular resources. So what you do is you just go to WP content, uploads, and then you say edge cache TTL, you set this to a month, and then you have to go to your cache level and declare it as cache everything. This is why we had to declare the uploads folder to avoid issues. When you're using WordPress to store audio files and video files, they all go to the uploads folder by default. However, other plugins and themes and other resources do get added to the WP content directory, so we wanted to make sure that we weren't running into any strange issues. So we clicked here, we click a month, we have cache everything, and then you can do the browser cache TTL and set it to a year because it'll match everything in the uploads folder. After you do this, you just hit save and deploy, and then you need to go to your website and view the resource. So you go to the website once, or you use something like GT Matrix, you test it twice, and then the MP4 or your MP3 files should all begin to be downloaded. You can also use this for other files such as flash files, books, PDFs, anything that is in the uploads folder will now be cached. It has a maximum duration of a month in the Cloudflare Edge cache, and the user's browser cache will save it for a year. If you have any specific questions about this integration, please feel free to ask in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.